Hey, it's Sheryl here. I just recently went through a rebranding, and that means a whole new set of fonts. And when I went to create one of my videos today, I realized, oh no, my favorite video editing app, InShot, doesn't have the new fonts in it. So I had to go through the process of re-importing my custom fonts into the app, and I thought this would be a good tutorial to share with you as well. So have a look. I'm going to share my screen with you. It's a little bit small on this format of video for YouTube, but nonetheless, you'll be able to follow along on my screen and on my phone exactly how I do it. So have a watch. Okay, so you're going to need a few different tools to make this work. You're going to need the InShot app installed on your phone, and you're also going to need the AnyFont app installed on your phone as well. We're also going to open a browser window, and I'm going to go to fonts.google.com. You can choose to get your fonts from a foundry or anywhere that you want to get your fonts from. I'm using Google as an example here. It's easy to use and free. So let's go into the search bar, and I could search for really like any font style that I want. So let's just say Lato is the one that I'm after. I'm gonna click on that font family, and let's say I want to choose the first one, Thin 100. Okay, so I'm just gonna click that. I'm gonna go up to the top right-hand side, and I'm going to click on the download button. Click download. And there it is. I don't think if you click on, no, you won't be able to get it from there. Okay, great. So now let's go over to the AnyFont app. You open the AnyFont app, this is what it will look like. And you will click on the plus sign at the top, go to iCloud Drive, and we want to locate the file that we just downloaded, the Lato zip file. So I'm gonna click on that, and you can see that it appears right here in the folders. So now let's open that. It actually downloaded all the whole family, actually, interestingly enough. So why don't we choose Lato, we said light, right? Is that the one we were looking at? Okay. So now I'm going to click on the install button, like it says. I'm gonna allow. And now it says, review the profile in settings app if you want to install it. So I'm going to click close, and I'll do exactly what it said to do. I'm going to go over to the settings, and I'm going to, so here's how it would look. I'm going to go to settings, going to go to general, going to go to profiles, and there it is at the top, Lato Light downloaded profile. So I'm going to click on that, and I'm going to say install. I'll add my passcode. Oh, here's my passcode. There we go. And I'm going to hit next, and I'll say install. Done. So it should be in there now somewhere. There it is right there, the Lato Light. Okay. So now let's go back to the AnyFont app. Click on Lato Light. You see there's a check mark now, and I'm going to click on the box at the top with the arrow pointing up, and now I'm going to pull my apps all the way over to the right hand side. If I don't see the InShot app here, I'll click on more. Now I'm going to scroll down my apps list, and there's copy to InShot, imported successfully. Great. So now I'm going to, let's just say I'm starting a new project, and I will choose this little video with Nicole. Okay, so now let's say I wanted to add some text on top of this. I'm gonna click the text button. I'll just put
import custom font, whatever words you want to put on the screen. Move this over. Let's make this a little larger so we can see it well. Great. And let's see, let's change that. We should be able to go through here now. And there it is, Lato Light. See it, how it appeared in the list here. Click on the check mark, and there you go. You have your custom font imported into InShot.
I love this trick because it customizes the experience. It customizes your edits in InShot. And the next video to watch is my two-step vlog hack, which I'll link to below this video.